who would be ready and able to deploy at any moment. And when they come to a community, they in turn would train the community in these skills, and they double or triple their efforts in finding a welcome. Today's media workshop is also dedicated to a young woman who was just found 3 days ago in North Dakota. And I spoke with her brother just yesterday. And he's very excited about an idea that I hope to, that comes true. I want to organize a national conference on murder and missing Native women. I think we all need to come together and tell our stories and receive healing from each other. In order to do something like this, I would imagine it would take 8 to 12 months to organize and bring in everyone. I've now been in conversation with 3 different families outside of California here, and they seem to be very excited about that possibility. We just have to make it happen. Oftentimes, great things start very small, like here. And so that's how I'm looking at it. And I know that in the end, we will receive the healing that we're looking for. And I'm here not because I've had that experience, but I know that in my heart, I'm supposed to be here. And the work that I'm doing with my nephew is called Balance. Male and female. That's why he's showing up here today. And with Emily, his companion, look at her face and you see me at 23. She looks almost exactly as I did when I was younger. Interesting choice. So I'd like to dedicate this day to Olivia Longbear. And her family, she is the mother of 5. And she, like all the other missing and murdered Native women, almost all of them had children, but they left behind. So our effort here is to try to heal what is broken here in this room. And I hope that it goes out into the world. So, after you find out if there's an event, you schedule your event, and then you come together, you get a huge calendar, one that you can really see, and you appoint people who want to do the work to keep track of when you send a press release out. You send one to yourself. Nowadays, it used to just be, once upon a time, it just used to be just snail mail. Well, now most news agencies expect you to email. So what we're gonna do here, because I don't have a scribe, I'm just gonna tell you the nuts and bolts of how to put a press release together. And in your packet, there is an example draft that I did some time ago, and just a moment. It looks like this. Study it, so a news agency calls, they'll be able to answer questions right now. I would like to have this press release go out about 3 days before Thomas appears before the judge. And what I'll do is I will compose the press release, and then upon the approval of the family, I'll send it out. I'm going to be emailing that press release to the family for their approval. And the first line of the press release has to be a grabber. It's called a hook. And it's supposed to get their attention. Something about Khadijah, for example, the fact that she's been missing for 6 months, the fact that law enforcement has not been able to do much more than what they have, and that it's important for us to come together and figure out our solutions. The question is should be better space, and it should be more than 1 page long. I'm not sure the president of the United States or the mission of some celebrity. There's no need for your press release to be any longer than that. Once you got that done and you send it out, then the real work begins. You have all previous press coverage, and you have a page called the information page, and it lists all the people involved. Now, I couldn't put an information page for this meeting workshop because I don't have the contact information. So I'll depend on one of you to give me that, if you can, including Dallas's contact information, his family, his friends. So when the press does a story on Khadijah, they will have those contacts in their hand. The press by the staring at you is pretty amazing. If we can do the work for them, they're very appreciative and they're more likely to do the story. When a press release is considered, it's sent to the assignment director. He's the person, or she's the person, that assigns reporters to do the story, usually between the hours of 7 and 9. And when you send it out, you send one to yourself. I'm going to be doing some mailouts as well. You send one to yourself to determine when the date of their press release. You call them up, and you say, I represent the family of Khadijah Britton. Have you received our press release? And they'll look, and they'll either say, no, we haven't. And you have a list of all the media that you've called, that you've sent out the press release. And you know whether they've received the press release or not. And you put a check on it. Then you ask them, is there any, we will get this information in. You have to study the press release so you can tell the press what it's about. And that we will show you that you will get the press release to you as soon as possible. You usually pick four people, as I was saying, with four different voice tones. This is the impression that you have a professional public relations person doing the work, and it's just you and I. And when you do that, they're impressed because the way that the press release is composed, it's professional, and they don't have to read pages. Organizations don't know how to write a press release. They